God is canvassing that here I have come, Puritranaya Sadunam, Vinashaya Sudhuskita. I have appeared before you just to give you relief. Puritranaya Sadunam, you are trying to understand me. So yes, I am present. Where you are thinking God is formless, here I am, Krishna, form. You see, I have got my fruit in the hand. I am very much fond of the cow. I love the cows and the sage and Brahma, everyone equally, because they are all my sons in different bodies. Krishna is playing, Krishna is speaking, still these rascals will not understand Krishna. So what is Krishna's fault? It is our fault. Andha. Just like the owl will never open the eyes to see that there is sunlight. You know this, owl? So they will not open. However, you may say, Mr. Owl, please open your eyes to see the sun. No, there is no sun. I don't see. This owl civilization. So you have to fight with these owls. It must be very strong, especially the sannyasis. You have to fight with the owls. You have to open their eyes by force, and this, with machine. This is going on. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is a fight against all the owls. Here is a challenge. Juyangvai dharma rajasya jadi niddesha karya. Niddesha karya. Servant means they have no second choice than to carry out the orders of the master. Therefore, niddesha karya. They cannot argue. No. Whatever is ordered, that is servant. So if anyone claims to become, he is expecting the, Vishnu Dutas are also mentioned here, Vasu Divoktakar, you know. They are also servants. So Ukta means whatever order is given by Vasudev, they carry out. Similarly, the Yamadutas, they are servants of Yamaraja, they are also at the Niddesha Karina. If you are actually servant of Yamaraja, you act according to his direction, then you must know what is dharma and what is adharma. So they are actually bona fide servant of Yamaraja. There is no doubt about it. Now they are giving their identification in this way. Yamaduruta Ukshu Vedapunehito dharma. Immediately. What is dharma? That was the question. Immediately answer. They know what is dharma. Vedapunehito dharma. Dharma means what is explained in the Vedas. You cannot create dharma. Veda, the original knowledge. Veda means knowledge. Veda Shastra. So, from the time of creation, the Veda was given to Brahma. Veda, therefore, is called apaurasya. It is not manufactured. That is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Tene Brahma Rida Adhikavahi. Brahma. Brahma means Veda. Veda is another name is Veda. Brahma. Spiritual knowledge. Or all knowledge. Brahma. So Tene Brahma Adhikavahi Rida. The Veda has to be studied from the spiritual master. So it is said that the Brahma is the first living being who understood Veda. So how he understood? Where is the teacher? There is no other creature. How he understood Vedas? The teacher was Krishna, and he is situated in everyone's heart. Ishara sarva-bhutanam hriddeshe Arjuna tishti. So he is teaching from the heart. So Krishna teaches, he is so kind, as Chaitya Guru, from the heart, and he sends his representative from outside. Chaitya Guru and Guru, both ways Krishna is trying. Krishna is so kind. So therefore, Vedas, they are not man-made books. Veda, apurvaisha. Apurvaisha means not made by, we should not take Vedas as ordinary mental speculation book. No, it is perfect knowledge. It is perfect knowledge, and one has to take as it is, without any adulteration, interpretation. So, it is spoken by God. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is also Veda. It's spoken by Krishna. So you cannot make any addition or alteration. You must take it as it is. Then you get the right knowledge. Vedas, how? The example is given, perhaps you know several times. But the Vedas, how it should be accepted as it is, without interpretation. Just like Vedas says that if you touch stool, immediately you have to take your bath. You have become impure. This is Vedic injunction. If you touch bone, then you have become impure. You have to take your bath immediately, full. Then Veda says, now this stool of cow is pure. Cow dung. Now, with your reason you can say, first of all, you said that stool is impure, and as soon as you touch, you must take your bathing, otherwise you remain impure. And another stool, cow stool, you say pure. This is contradiction. You say that the bone is impure, and you are keeping the bone in the deity's room. The concept is born. You know this concept is born of an animal. So it is being used in the deity room, and the cow dung is also used in the deity room. Even Krishna is smearing his whole body with cow dung. You know Krishna is Lila. So if you say, argo, with your poor knowledge, then it becomes contradiction. One stool is good, another stool is bad. But because it is said by the Vedas, you have to accept. This is Vedic knowledge. You cannot argue. There is no scope of argument. Whatever is said, you have to accept. Otherwise, how Vedas become authority? You can change in your own way. So therefore, we say that if you want to take benefit by reading Bhagavad Gita, then you should accept it as it is said. Don't try to interpret foolishly, then you never get it. That is our propaganda. And people are very against us. No, I am a scholar. I am a philosopher, I can interpret in any way. We say, no, sir, you cannot do that. This is our problem. Be the Panihita. Thank you very much.